Well, y'all, 2013 is sneaking up on us quicker than a duck on a June bug. Hi, I am June Klein. I'm the Southern Sassy and Savvy Humorist, helping people, teams, and companies and associations to lighten up and have fun so they can get paid more. You know, since the apocalypse didn't happen, I'm figuring it's time to start making some plans on how I want 2013 to look. And one of the things that I love to do is a vision board. Now, if you don't know what that is, it is simply a process where you take pictures out of magazines, preferably your own. I have found that friends, neighbors, and companies do not like it when you tear a picture out of their magazine. So get your own and look through those magazines and start to identify pictures that represent what you would love to have in your life for 2013. So that's the basic premise of creating a vision board. Then you glue those pictures onto a cardboard, a piece of poster paper, or some put it in a scrapbook, either way. And you have those there to look at and to visualize what you want in your world. So the three V's of vision boarding are these. Number one is, just as I was saying, visualize. Visualize what you really, truly, truly want in your world, and you'll begin to find the pictures and be able to see. It is said that once we can get a clear picture in our mind, then we start to resonate that vibration, that frequency, and we actually draw it to us. An example is, if you've ever wanted a car and you decide upon the color and the style that you want, don't you begin to see it everywhere? And oftentimes in colors that you didn't even know existed. So that's exactly what this is doing. It's pulling that to you, that which is already out there, but now you've decided that you want it. The second V is value. It must be valued. You must value this. You must want it. It's from I call it the trifecta. You have to want it from your head, your heart, and your soul. So if you value something and you say you want it, then chances are it will actually show up. I remember hearing an evangelist, as a matter of fact, I wrote about this in my book called Is It God or Is It Gas? Intuition versus Indigestion. And I wrote about seeing a TV evangelist that said, my notes were just falling right there off in front of the screen. Now see how that's happening? That is not sticky. It ain't going to stay. So you'll be noticing me looking down instead of up at my little cheat sheet. So back to the TV evangelist. What he was saying was, if you want a brown Mercedes, then God wants you to do something with that brown Mercedes. God will not put a desire in you that you will not be able to do and use for his work. Now, I don't know if that's true for you, but I do know that our desire, I believe our passion and our desire comes from within. So unless you really value this, it is not going to happen. Another example I have of that is a friend of mine, 1997, said, I'm going to make $97,000 this year. That was her income goal. And I just thought, wow, that's cool. That's a great idea. I think I will too. And I said, you know what? Me too. I'm going to put down $97,000 as my goal, my income goal that year. Well, the thing is, she valued it enough to go after it and to do it. And for me, it was just an arbitrary number that felt right because she was doing it. Needless to say, I did not make $97,000 that year, but she was spot on it. So again, it goes back to being valued by you. And then last but not least is the third V, is viable. That means it's got to resonate and be so true for you that you are capable of doing this, that you are motivated enough to do it, and that you can actually have a chance of this thing working out. So if it's not viable for you on every level, I think I forgot to tell you earlier the three areas, the trifecta, the head, the heart, and the soul. the head, the heart, and the soul. If it doesn't come out of all three of those areas, face it, Bunky, it ain't gonna happen. So here we are looking at 2013. I mean, like a freight train coming at us, it is light. And if we plan this right and we step out there on our own beliefs of what we value, what we're willing to visualize and create, and then what we value, and then what is viable to us, meaning that we are capable and willing to do it, I know we can create the best 2013 ever. Now, my girlfriend, Myra McElhaney, she's a speaker and an author, an amazing woman, and I will be doing a workshop in January the 10th, on the 10th, and on the 15th in Atlanta, Georgia. We will be actually doing vision boards, and people will be creating them right then. If you would like more information about that, then go ahead and leave me a comment and we will get that information to you. And also remember to go to junekline.com, subscribe, and you'll always know what's going on here.